How y'all doing, family? This Chris Rye with Media TV, and I'm going to be coming to you with this news from the BaltimoreSun.com. It says news, Maryland education, K-12 education. And I'm going to be getting to the school system from Baltimore. It says Baltimore students score near the bottom in reading, math on key national assessment. And this was published on April 10th, 2018 by Liz Bowie, contact reporter. It says Baltimore City students score near the bottom in reading and math compared to children in other cities in large urban areas on important national assessment given in 2017, according to scores released Tuesday morning. It says in 4th and 8th grade reading, only 13% of city students are considered proficient or advanced in 4th grade math. 14% were proficient, and in 8th grade math, 11% met the mark. According to the National Assessment of Education Progress, a federal mandate test from the U.S. Department of Education, and it says that put the Baltimore ahead of only Detroit and Cleveland, and sometimes ahead of Milwaukee and Fresno, California, areas of the country that also suffer from high poverty and crime. These results underscore the urgency of the work we are now doing to ensure our students achieve a higher level, said Baltimore City Schools CEO Sandra Santelices. In a statement, she declined to be interview. But my thing is, before I go further down and read more, is I blame this on Baltimore, as a whole, because my thing is, okay, y'all think about this, family. Y'all know Baltimore City is so, like, It's so fucking jacked up right now. Like, it's bad because, you know, poverty with the cops fucking with us and shit like that. You know, fucking with our black royal family down there as well. So, how can kids come home and read if they have to worry about, you know, either getting shot or something like that, or they have to worry about getting robbed on their way to home? I didn't have to worry about, if their mom's going to be there at the house or not, or if their dad going to be at the house or not. You know, they always have to worry about other things other than school. You feel what I'm saying? Put yourself in their shoes. And they're kind of like saying, like, you know, like they dumb or something. They're not dumb. They're not dumb. It's just taking them a longer time because they have more things that they have to deal with in life, they have to deal with other than school. So they don't really have the amount of time like everyone else does. But it's still some other cities that's real fucked up as well, shit like that. But Baltimore City is real, it's so fucking crooked. Damn near everybody, like every person is black, is damn near dying a day. Or more, you feel what I'm saying? It's just so corrupt down there. It's fucked up. So how can they expect for the kids to be able to pay attention to, you know, school alone, because they have so much other stuff that they have to worry about? You know, some kids are living outside. Some kids are, you know, the only thing that they have right now is either trapping, selling weed, selling pills or something like that, or, you know, either prostituting their body, doing some kind of things that they probably need the money for or something like that. And I'm not saying that that's good, and I'm not saying that that's great, but when you're in like a bad fucked up situation, and it seems like no one down there is trying to, you know, help them out or anything like that. And a lot of schools are closing down there. A lot of schools are closing down there, and they don't really have the money for a lot of other things. So it's like, What else can he do? But let me get more into this article. It says the statement says the district is working to focus on literacy to improve student achievement in language art and other subjects, and is trying to train principals better. Baltimore has introduced a new math curriculum this year and will move to a new English curriculum next year. It says Santa is one of the first city school leaders in a decade to focus on curriculum and academic reform rather than structural changes within the school system. Academic reforms rather than the structural changes within the school system. It says Baltimore and Maryland scores remain essentially flat on the assessment, also known as the nation's report card, mirroring a national trend. Florida, Georgia, and Massachusetts were among the states that showed significant increases in eighth grade reading proficiency. Nationwide scores were flat on the tests, which is considered the longest running and most reliable assessment of what U.S. students know in reading and math in the fourth and eighth grades. It says the National Assessment of Education Progress is required by law to be given to a sampling of U.S. students every 2 years. It is the only national test that allows educational achievement of states and cities to be compared. In addition, in two dozen cities, including Baltimore, have voluntarily chosen to have a larger sample of student tests in order to receive results specific to their cities. Baltimore began giving the test to more students in 2009. Some cities, including Washington, Miami, and Fresno, California, have reported significant increases in achievement, while Baltimore scores have generally gone down in the past 8 years. Yeah, because they're not doing what they need to do. The school system down there is not doing what they need to do. The cities down there is not doing what they need to do. How can they understand and do everything and learn everything that they need to get if they're continuing to get old books, if they're continuing school not getting funded, if teachers take the initiative to try to go above and beyond and try to help out some students, but some other students don't want to learn. But at the same time, you know, it takes a collective of everybody working together to try to make this happen if they really want to make it work. So let's see, get back into it. It says nationally, Maryland fourth graders ranked 13th in reading and 24th in math, while the state's high graders ranked 23rd in reading and 33rd in math. Said 2 years ago, the state experienced an historic drop in scores that education officials partially attributed to the fact that the state's previously excluded too many special education students from taking the test more than was allowed. Maryland went from one of the top performing states to the middle of the pack among the states. State Department of Education officials declined to be interviewed Monday, but said in a statement that for the first time the state had included enough students with disability and English language learners to meet targets set by the federal government. It says in fourth grade math and reading and eighth grade reading, Maryland scores were above the national average. Eighth grade math scores were slightly below the national average. The state did not release the percentage of students proficient in reading and math on Tuesday morning. Spokesman said the department had not had time to analyze the data. Why y'all didn't have time to analyze the data? Y'all have people working there. Y'all should have time to analyze the damn data. Y'all got time to analyze everything else, but you don't have time to analyze the motherfucking data. It says one national trend that has become apparent is the growing disparity between the lowest performing students and the high performing. The percentage of the lowest performers is increasing over time, but so is the percentage of students who are high scores. Students' achievement is often linked to family income, and there is a growing income gap in students enrolled in public schools. Of course, because most, the fact of the matter is, and it's just the truth, more kids that's in public schools are more poor than kids are in, you know what I'm saying, boarding school, all these other schools and high class preppy schools and shit like that. So is you gotta understand, as public school is getting funded by the school system and shit like that, which is getting funded from, you know, the banks and the federal government and shit like that, and the school system. So, and depending on what public schools get funded and get and raise more money and stuff like that, and depending on, you know, if you're in the inner city or the suburbs or anything like that, you know, it determines how much money you're going to get for your school. And it depends on who spend the money wisely and how much they get. And it just goes up, it goes from the top on down. So, like I say, it's kind of, it's real fucked up, because at the same time, what's going to happen is, because a lot of schools in Baltimore, if you have overwhelming kids that's, you know, that's not up to reading level or math level the way they should be, it's kids gonna start dropping out when they get to either ninth grade or 10th grade, and they feel like it's too hard, or nobody's not trying to help them, or they're not trying to ask for help or anything, and it just become too hard for them. They're going to drop out, and then the only thing that they're going to have is either working at fast food places or stuff like that, or selling drugs or selling weed or something like that. And that becomes their reality because of, you know, nobody didn't take the time to do what they were supposed to do with the kids. Or the mother or the father wasn't there because of other things that's going on. It's just so much of stuff, you know. It's a lot of stuff going on down there in Baltimore City to where they're failing the kids. And the kids are their future. The kids are their future. So there is a reflection of what's going to happen in their future for the older parents and for senior citizens. Because if people are dying down there and the kids not getting the right education that they need to get, you know, because they're supposed to be the future of, you know, to be the next doctors, the next teachers, you know, firefighters and stuff like that, who's going to do the job when, you know, at a certain point of time when people die over time and stuff like that, you know, with the next 15, 20 years, you know, a lot of people won't be certified or like in Detroit, it'd be bankrupt. So they need to do something. They need to do something about that, because it's just too bad, man. And I don't see them doing what they need to do. And they need to push for and, you know, do their jobs, man. But, family, I want y'all to let me know what y'all think about this. This Baltimore City, you know, about the students' lower test scores and stuff like that. I'll put the link in the description. Let me know what y'all think about this story in the comment. Drop that like button. Hit that like button. Subscribe. Donate to the PayPal. I'll put in the link in the description below. And I'll be back with another one. Your boy is back.